Hey guys, how you guys doing? It's Carolina Diamond, and right now I'm working on something very special in the kitchen where it requires me to, you know, just basically do an upload video. Just want to take my time, just getting into editing, and you know, doing my videos and you know, enjoying it. Normally I will go live and have you guys on here and you guys will be helping me cook, but tonight I decided, you know, with the thunderstorms and everything, that I would try to do it this way, and then you know, I could take my time and learn my editing and bring you guys better videos. But for this video, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking some stewed beef, and I'm going to season it real good, and we're going to saute it in an Instant Pot, and we're going to get on and start cooking. The directions is not that hard, and you know, and hopefully it comes out, you know, something you guys can share with your family and hope you enjoy. But anyway, I'm going to turn this camera and let you guys see what I'm about to do. I'm about to take my stewed beef, which I already have over here, guys, in this thing already, you know, unthawing and frosting. So what I'm going to do now is take out my my stopper in my sink so I can drain it. And I'm going to go ahead and wash the meat. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day, wonderful evening. If you're here in the United States or you guys watching me overseas, much love to you. But first of all, before I do that, I'm going to go ahead and, you know, tidy up my kitchen a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and place this over to the side. And basically, you know, just freelance video, you know, uploading and take my time in the kitchen. So I'm going to put this to the side. Let me start washing my dishes. Man, today has been an amazing day. Started out a little bit, you know, kind of warm, but it finally rained. Getting all the rain and, you know, getting us out of this drought that we are here in the North Carolina, South Carolina area. Hope wherever you are, you guys are doing great. Getting that much needed rain and cool weather. A whole lot better than it was about 4 weeks ago, guys. We have a temperature of 101 and basically the heat index was 106 and honey, I remember my air conditioner went out. Oh my God, it was just so hot. But you know, I'm thankful right now with the great weather that we're having now. So, y'all just give me 1 minute. I'm gonna go ahead and clean up my kitchen here so we can go ahead and get started. It's kind of late here right now. It's Sunday, 9:05. So, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and clean the kitchen, get this video uploaded. Hope you guys enjoy it. For some reason, I noticed my water pressure is getting better. And that's a good thing. I like that. Yeah, today, you know, has been a beautiful day. I didn't go to church today, so I just pretty much stayed at home today and listened to Bishop T.D. Jakes and had a great time listening to a couple of his sermons. And I just pretty much laid back and relaxed at home and finally went out about, I guess it was about 2 or 3 o'clock, went to the grocery store. Got a couple items and things of that nature. Talked to a couple of relatives, my uncles, and just hung out for a little while. We're just getting back, so. And I was debating whether I was going to cook tonight. I was like, you know what? Let's do this upload thing. Video upload. Yeah, I'm just basically washing my dishes. And I'm going to go back and look at this video in its entirety before I upload and make sure that, you know, it's good quality. You know, nothing off the wall or anything to cause me not to like the video. So, and hope you guys enjoy it. So I know you guys are going to watch this on the playback because it's not live, but so tell me some of the things you guys did today. I mean, what did you go out and spend time with your family? Did you stay at home on this beautiful Sunday? You know, just let me know in the comments what you did. You know, guys, I don't know if you caught the video that I did earlier today where Joe Biden says he's not going to run for a 2024 president's election, and he's nominating Vice President Harris to be, he's endorsing her to run for president. So if you guys haven't heard that, watch the my earlier video when, you know, Joe Biden decides to come up the trail and not for run for president in 2024. A lot of people are happy about that, and a lot of people dislike it because, you know, you got a lot of Donald Trump supporters.
But whatever that you decide to vote for, or who you decide to vote for, just as long as you vote, that's the most important thing. And, you know, let's sit back and, you know, be adult about this whole thing, about this election thing, because, you know, people can get outraged about the whole thing. But, you know, as long as you vote, that's the most important thing, and that the issue that you vote for and the candidate that you choose, hey, that's entirely your amendment right. So, but, you know, it was just, to me, it was a big surprise to see that. And also, I noticed the women's NBA guys are back on TV this weekend. They had the shootout and all that stuff. So that was, you know, something great to see that finally came on TV. Because you guys know I love basketball. I haven't been into it like I normally be with the NBA, like the males. But I'm getting into, you know, with the women's NBA. It's pretty cool. I like to have a lot of space to move around here before I start cooking, and I'm trying to go ahead and get organized as well. I haven't talked to my daughters today, so I know they're doing great. They're doing great, marvelous things. So I'll probably give them a call tomorrow, because it's kind of late right now with my grandson. He's probably is rest on, and my daughter, I know she's trying to get her some quality time, because, you know, no matter what, we mothers, we need a little time to ourselves, you know. So I'm just going to enjoy the night tonight. But anyway, guys, what I'm planning on doing with this stew beef is basically, you know, make a nice stew beef and cook some lima beans and maybe corn, maybe rice. I haven't really decided about my vegetables yet, but the most important thing, what I want to do is just get it in the Instant Pot. And then, you know, of course, once I get it on, we have about 30 minutes worth to cook as an entire, and then I can decide on what vegetables I want to cook along with the lima beans. Because, you know, who loves the lima beans other than Mr. Myers? But anyway, I pretty much got it clean and everything organized like I wanted to, so I'm going to get back to the meat. And what I'm basically going to do now, right, is just so you guys can see. I might end up plugging up my laptop, because I don't know if it's going to be on. The battery is about to die, not so. But, you know, if it gets to that point, I'll go grab my cord. But what I'm going to do now, guys, always do what? Wash your meat. I make sure that it's clean, good to go. So this is about 5 pounds of, let me get it right, of stew beef. And the recipe calls for 2 pounds, about 2 pounds. So what I'm gonna do is take, wash this, and then the other half, I'm just gonna put the other half up in the freezer so it can, you know, we can use it for another day. So I'm putting half of that in there now. And what I'm gonna do now is basically take some more saran wrap and wrap this up and use this for another day. As you can see, it's half of the actual recipe, so. Normally, if I was just using just the stove or baking, I would use the whole thing. But with the Instant Pot, you know, I'm not really that good in cooking stew beef. Matter of fact, this is going to be my first try cooking stew beef in the Instant Pot. And I know it's going to come out right, so I just want to basically go ahead and go by the directions that I watched on YouTube. So this has come out just right. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this back up, as you guys can see. Right, be very careful with that saran wrap, because I tell you, if you don't get it the right way, it'll just tear in many places. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this back up. And make sure that you do it this way like I do. Just make sure that you wrap all the openings up so it doesn't get freezer burnt. Go ahead and continue to wrap that around. And some of you guys like to go ahead and put on dates on your food or just your freezing to ensure that, you know, you don't go past the freezer. But me, since I like to cook so much, I'm probably going to use this for another recipe, like a soup or something. Later on this week, I'm just going to do it just like that and just stick it inside the refrigerator. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and wash the meat. Put this to the side. Okay. Put this away. I'm going to wash it real good.
go ahead and press it about the bowl.
Wash it a little bit. Yeah. Make sure you wash your meat really well. That's why a lot of people get food poisoning and things like that. You go to the restaurant, you're not sure who's cooking the food or where the case may be, and you don't know if it's washed. But when you're at home cooking your food, you know exactly how it's supposed to be. Nice and clean, you know, make sure you wash all that residue off in it. And then once I do that, I'm gonna go ahead and place it on this plate and go ahead and begin to season it and prep it for the Instapot. And the first thing we're gonna do when we do the Instapot, we're gonna put it on we're gonna put it on saute, because basically what I wanna do is go ahead and, you know, make sure get the meat nice and brown on both sides. And I'm gonna put my onions in there and put about a half a cup of olive oil to make sure that, you know, you sear it on both sides and it comes out right. Let me drop a sink right now. But yeah, the seasoning that I'm gonna use basically for the just to brown the meat, saute the meat in the Instant Pot is just gonna be, you know, a little bit of salt, pepper. You guys can do your seasoning however you want to. But this is just to sear it right now. Make sure it's, you know, nice and brown on both sides. Not too much salt, but just a little bit to wake up the flavor. Guys, you probably can't see it on video, but I'm just putting lightly sprinkling on both sides. And I'm going to go ahead and put me a little black pepper here. By the time I get my nails cut, I tell you, it's like it stopped me from doing a lot of stuff, like especially playing ball. But, you know, in due time I get there, because I'm doing a lot of cardio right now and going to the gym, pumping some iron. I'm just, you know, put a little bit more pepper than I did with the salt, because I like for it to go ahead and, you know, to wake up the flavor when I sear the meat. So we got that going. And what you guys can, I'll be right back. Okay, guys, now that I'm back, what I'm going to do now is turn you guys around to the Instant Pot. As you can see, we turn the light so we can all see a little bit better. Give me just a second. Yes, I'm trying to get up and personal tonight, y'all. It's video. So when I bring it to you tomorrow, when I do upload, you guys can see everything that I see. So what the first thing we're going to do right now, guys, as you can see, is to saute. Let me get my glasses so I can see as well. I can see all these little gadgets. I have a magic bullet and everything else. But what I'm going to do now is plug up the Instant Pot. Yeah, it was a thunderstorm today, so I unplugged everything, guys, to make sure that everything was safe. So first thing I'm going to do, pull this to the side, get this out of my way so you guys can see exactly what's going on. So, but here's the thing. I'm going to take the lid off. Wait a minute. Take the lid off. Thank you.
And I'm gonna remove the meat thing here. And we're gonna go ahead and push saute, which is right here. And just let it go. And then we're gonna put a tablespoon of olive oil. Don't worry about the meat. When you see, guys, you see that on, it means that it's on saute, it's ready for the oil. And as you guys can see, for this video purpose, I'm using olive oil. It's called Flippo Beto Olives olive oil. I love it, it's very good. And I'll put about a tablespoon worth in there. Don't worry, guys, if you put a little bit too much, it's kind of like idiot proof, you can't mess it up. Excuse my choice of words, but it's really easy. You guys, give me just a second, I'll be right back. Okay, guys, now that I'm doing, what I'm going to do right now is my Instant Pot is really warming up. What I went ahead and did, I added about a tablespoon of salt, tablespoon of black pepper, and I'm going to go ahead and place it in. As you guys can hear, it's searing. Place the meat inside, and since it's nice and warmed up, and I'm going to put a cup of onion so they can all saute together. I'm going to show you what it looks like in just a minute. But while that's going, I'm going to go ahead and cut up my onions because I haven't done that yet.
Take your time, you know.
Can't burn anything up unless you are not adding enough ingredients. But it's going to come out just right. I got to get my onion, guys. I should have cut that up first, but I didn't. But anyway, we're going to just fry it here. So I'm going to take that long to cut up an onion. And since it's searing, guys, the only thing you got to pretty much is, you know, it was smelling so good already. I'm trying to catch up. So, moving this to the side. I'm going to wash my onion off. Oh, Lord, I better go ahead and turn that meat. I'm going to put you guys back here so you guys can see what I'm doing. So, I have a little bit of room. As you can see, I'm just going to basically stir up the meat. Once the meat, you know, gets a brown, golden brown on both sides, I'll let you guys see it. You want to go ahead and remove the meat from the Instant Pot and do what we call a deglaze. Basically, you can take a cup of alcohol, since I don't drink alcohol. I'm going to use a cup of broth to leave it in, and you basically
What you're gonna do is clean the sides off, making sure that you know you don't get a burn notice on your Instapot. Just make sure that you know you clean out all the sides or whatever. You guys wanna see me? I'm just waiting to do the meat is brown on both sides, so that's gonna be a little while. Probably about 5 minutes. And it smells so good. Oh Lord. Oh yes, y'all. I am so ready. So I'm gonna let this go for a little while. And while that's doing that, I'll clean my meat. But while you're searing, notice guys, when you saute that you don't put the lid on it, just pretty much, you know, what you're doing is just kind of like frying it like you're doing the stove top, but you're doing it inside the Instant Pot. So I'm watching the meat, making sure that, you know, it's getting golden brown on both sides. I'll clean up this real quick and I'll let you guys see what's going on inside my Instant Pot. Oh, this is another oh so good. Clean up my mess here. Put the lid to the side. The next time, making my mental note is that I'll go ahead and cut up my onion before I put it inside the Instant Pot. Yeah, and you know, you make sure that, you know, everything is good to go. I love cleaning up my kitchen. I can't stand it to cook in a dirty kitchen, so I'm just cleaning up as I go. And while that's stirring, while that's going to continue to stir a little bit more, you're going to try out this one. So good. Oh, yes. And here I am, guys, just, you know, basically cleaning up my mess. Hope I don't have to do too much editing to this video. I may just go ahead and upload so you guys can see the blunders and the bloopers in the kitchen, because, you know, things do happen, but the most important thing is maintaining and driving on, you know? So I may not do too much editing, just let it go like it is. Because I'm so used to having y'all with me when I go live stream. I try to, you know, go ahead and do everything live, but tonight is a different thing for me, just uploading a video. So, you know, it's my chance to learn how to edit and get it right. I'll let that go for about 2 more minutes. Okay, guys, I am back. I'm going to go ahead and stir up the meat one more time to make sure that both the brown sides are, the sides are nice and brown on the meat, and that, you know, the onions begin to soften. So since this is a little, these stew is a little bit thick, I'm going to continue to let it go for a few more minutes. And then, you know, once the meat gets done on both sides and the onion begin to soften, what you basically want to do is begin to deglaze. Like I indicated before, if you don't drink like I don't drink. So basically what I'm going to do is take a cup of chicken broth to make sure I clean both out the sides so you don't get a burn notice. And a burn notice is like, you know, when next time you use your pot and you can get all the brown meat, you know, stickers of the meat off of the sides, and you'll get a notice from this. And that's something you don't want to do. So I suggest, you know, once you're done with your meat, when it gets to the right golden stuff, golden brown color that you want and your onions are just like you want to, then you know, go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna let it go for a few more minutes. Yes,
okay, go ahead and when Patty was here. Sure enough, about you.
Alrighty. So at this point, y'all, what I'm gonna do now is let it go for a few more minutes, y'all. Yeah. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go ahead, it's about right to me now, so I'm gonna go ahead and get a cup of chicken broth. Yep. And like I said before, let me show you guys what's going on now so y'all see what the actual meat looks like. And this is what it looks like. See? On the inside. See how it's searing up and it looks good in there? And basically what you want to do is just, you know, go ahead and move things around like so. Y'all, excuse me. I'm one-handed here using my laptop to make sure everything is, you know, onions are nice and soft and all the sides are, you know, golden brown and they're there right now. Okay. I'm going to put you guys back down. And I'm going to get a couple of chicken broth you guys can see. And deglaze my Instant Pot. Be extra careful. You're not used to your Instant Pot when you pour things in. You know, don't go so fast. Make sure it's nice and slow so you don't burn yourself. So this is golden broth. I'm gonna get my chicken broth. Excuse me, beef broth. And for tonight, guys, I'm using Swanson beef broth to deglaze my Instant Pot. And like I said, you use alcohol, you cover alcohol. But if you're like me, you don't use alcohol. Don't drink alcohol. A cup of beef broth will do. So you just pour it in there. And basically what you're going to do is clean up the sides, make sure that there's nothing sticking to the pot from the meat sticking to the pot. So I'm going to put this back up in the refrigerator and do that. And not only does it just clean up all the meat sticking to the pot, but it also gives your beef stew some flavor. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll let you guys see in just a minute. So I'm putting all the sides here. Yes, yes, yes. And this part right here is called deglazing. And all you're doing with deglazing, like I said before, making sure that all the meat that was, when we was searing, sauteing the meat, that all the meat markings, you know, scraping off the pot. Oh God, this smells so good. And I'm gonna let, you know, now that I've done that, I'm just gonna let it go ahead and, you know, marinate and some of that broth to give that extra flavor. So I'm gonna let this go for about 2 or 3 minutes. Yes, and I just wanna make sure that all those meat markers are off the pot. And if you like this recipe, please go ahead and share it out to your friends, your family. I hope you guys enjoy it. But for me, this is my first time actually doing the stew beef inside the Instant Pot. Normally, I'll do it on stovetop or, you know, just bake it. But right about now, only thing I'm doing right now is making sure that I get all of the meat markers off the side of the Instant Pot because you don't want to get a burn notice. And I pretty much got it. A lot of my friends just told me, they said, well, you know what, Stacey, you don't have to do all that, but, you know, do all that once you, you know, cook your stew beef, you go ahead and use a Brillo pad or whatever it is. And I was like, nope, I'm going to go by the directions on it. Because this Instant Pot got a warranty. I can honestly tell them, I did the glazes, I did get a burn up or something like that. So, but the meat is getting there. I'm going to let it sip about 5 more minutes, and it should be on point. Oh yeah, well, it smells real good, guys. It smells so good. But like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and give it another couple more minutes to make sure that beef rock gets down in that stew beef, honey. Lord Jesus, smells good. Yes, yes, yes. And of course, you know, these little beef tips, they're a little bit normally thick. So I just want to make sure that it gets to the point where it's nice and tender. So I'm going to give it about 5 more minutes. Wow, that meat really smells good, guys. Wow. Nice and tender. And basically what you want to do is you want the beef broth, or you use alcohol to deglaze the brown bits off the side of it and just let it sit there and cook and marinate, you know, the longer it sits. You know, guys, because depending on the size of your meat, the longer it sits, the better the flavor is going to be. So I'm going to give that additional about 3 minutes. I'm going to give it 3 more minutes. Oh, God, it smells so good. So good. So good. So good.
And in the meantime, while that's going, I'm going to get ready to put 3 cups of beef broth, 3 cups of potatoes, 2 cups of carrots, and 1 cup of crushed tomatoes.
This feels oh so good. So what I'm going to do now, guys, I'm going to push the cancel on my Instapot so you guys can see. And it's running outside. Can you guys believe that? We've been recording now for about 37 minutes, and I'm having a great time, you guys. I really am. So I'm going to push the cancel button. As you guys can see on my Instapot, see if I can lower it down. Oh, Jesus. Push cancel. You see it's zero. It's off. So I'm going to put this back on the table. So what I'm going to do now, guys, I'm going to tell you exactly what I'm going to add. I'm going to add 3 cups of low sodium beef broth. And this is the part where you're going to push pressure cook on your Instapot because you pretty much just want it to slow cook for 30 minutes and you want to control the temperature and the time. So you push pressure cook. But in the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and add, I don't know why I want to keep pulling out this bone broth, but this is for something else. But I'm going to put 3 cups of beef broth. And if you want a thinner soup, you go ahead and put 4 cups. And one thing I love about the Instapot, guys, once you turn it off, you can taste it, take your time. You can't really mess it up, you know? You really can't. So I'm going to put 3 cups of beef broth. One, two, three, and a whole house is sleeping right now, y'all. It's 9:30, everybody knocked out, so I can pretty much take my time and enjoy my, you know, enjoy this cooking. I gotta also put on my grocery list to get another thing of Swanson beef broth. Not being sponsored, but this is some good beef broth, y'all. And it's also, it doesn't cost that much in the grocery store. So next thing I'm going to do now is get my carrots, and I'm going to put 2 cups of carrots in there. Yes. So what I'm going to do is get my carrots. You know, you guys can get baby carrots, or you can basically, you know, get carrots in the can. No, however you want to do it. But for me, I'm going to get carrots that I already bought from Paper Weekly and wash them off and chop them up. And also, I got to remind myself to get another thing of carrots, too, y'all. So I'm going to throw this way, put on my groceries, beef broth, and carrots. So I'm going to do now is just take these carrots right here, wash them off, and go ahead and cut them up. You
get another knife, guys. I'm always, one thing about me, I love, for some reason, using all the utensils in my kitchen. I do. I already have a knife or a spoon already, but for some reason, I'll just go through them and just wash them. Just to have it. So I'm going to go ahead and, slice these up. They already clean. Just wash them off. And me, I like to go ahead and scrape them a little bit just to make sure that they're all even. You know, those root quality carrot is gone. Yeah. Yes, yes. I'm gonna go ahead and cut them off. I cut mine in very small pieces so you know he can marinate inside the stew beef a little bit. But you cut yours however you want it. So what I'm gonna do is just go ahead and wash these off once more. I don't know, I love making my cookies clean. And just manually just place them in there. I know pretty much it's about two cups as I put them in there. That's carrot number one. I can take my time, y'all. Everybody's loving it. I am so much loving it. I ain't got a brush, and you know, the Instant Pot gonna take its time, cook about 30 minutes or more, and I'm gonna let it sit there for an extra 15 minutes. Because after you cook your food and in the Instant Pot, once all the pressure, I'm gonna talk you guys through it. Once all the pressure leaves, you wanna let it sit there for an extra 15 minutes. Because you know, the longer it sits, the better your food, the much more tender it becomes. I'll let you guys know as we get to that point, but I'm still continuing to cut my carrots. You guys are going to see. I'm just making sure that I cut all the bruised part of the carrot off. You guys will know how you guys like it, do yours. I was talking to some friends online, and they said they basically like some people get the baby carrots, and others like to get their canned carrots. And I just thought maybe I'll try some fresh carrots because I already had some in my refrigerator, so. But what I'm going to continue to cut all the blue part off. And I'm going to cut them up. Oh, small pieces. I'm going to put 2 million in. That's a 2 cups. I'm going to see how this recipe turns out. I'm excited to do this, guys. I just want to see what it turns out because I love speaking to I do. So. And go ahead and wash this off. Again, I love washing my vegetables, make sure they're extra clean. Place those inside the pot. And you guys, when you want to get real effective about using it in the pot, and you get a little intimidated, don't be intimidated, first of all. Because, you know, it's too easy. You can't mess it up. But if you really, really want to take your time and enjoy it in the kitchen, do it while everybody's feet like I'm doing. And it's thunderstorming outside. And you know what? I love to cook. So this is all my time right now. Take my time. Yes. So I think I have enough carrots. I'm going to throw this one away because that one's a little bit of sound like my carrots too much. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up this mess here. Yeah, but next time, guys, when I do cook this stew, I'm going to go ahead and pretty much have my ingredients already cut up and prepared to start doing the Instant Pot. But tonight, y'all, we just chilling. There's a video upload. Hope you guys find it very, very interesting and hope you enjoy the recipe. Now that I have my 2 cups of carrots in there, I'm going to put 3 cups of potatoes. And for this one, guys, I'm debating if I'm going to use a can of potatoes or if I'm going to cut some up because I have potatoes now inside here. And they're a little old, so yeah, we got to get rid of that. We're going to use the cans instead. How about these potatoes? I think about 3 weeks ago. A little, especially when you start seeing a little
pouring out of it, don't use it. Do not use it. But anyway, when it comes to obesity, you can put any kind of brush on that you want to. And me, I'm just looking for a can of potatoes. If I don't have it, then I'm going to move on to something else. But I know I have a lot of potatoes. So what I'm going to do now is right in. I got my diced tomatoes I'm going to put out to the side. And please, oh, please tell me that I have some potatoes. And I know I do. Okay, we've got squash. Oh, God, I love squash. Okay, we've got potatoes here. You know what I'm going to do? Let me see. I'm trying to get a certain size on the can. And I did find some sliced potatoes, guys. Amen. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Jesus. And this is 2.5 servings. And the servings is 2/3 cup. So I'm just going to use one can of this inside of the Instapot. So let me go ahead and open that. Now I'm going to take the can over you guys and just open up the potatoes. Well, that was my intention. Let me use another can opener. Hopefully this one works. Okay, guys, guess what I gotta do? My can opener not working, so I'm gonna go old school and use a knife. So, but anyway, let me go ahead and get this one. And when you gotta get like this, guys, you wanna be extra careful. Because even though both my can openers are broken, I can use a knife and it's very sharp. So, but when you're in the kitchen, make sure that you practice safety. Take your time and don't rush. Don't be like me, you break two of your can openers and you meant to go to the store today and get one, but you totally forgot. But anyway, I'm gonna make it do what it do. I'm using my knife and I'm just going around it very, very carefully to make sure I can open it up and go ahead and put this can of potatoes inside of the Instapot. Make sure if you gotta do it like this, you know, you take your time. And you know, hey, we're getting there. Slowly but surely. I've got to give myself a memo to get 3 things. Beef broth, a can opener, and carrots. So, here we go, y'all. Yes. Okay. So what I'm going to do, be very careful. I'm just going to take this and go ahead and pour the can inside the Instapot. Yeah. So, I'm discarding that. And we're going to put a cup of crushed tomatoes. And we're going to have to do the same thing for these things that diced tomatoes. To me, diced tomatoes and crushed tomatoes are the same thing. So, I'm going to go ahead and use my diced tomatoes. I got these cans right here. On sale at Piggly Wiggly, it was like 5 for a dollar. So I got like 5 of them, tomatoes, I got squash, corn, and string beans. So I'm going to go ahead and open this. And it says it calls for a cup. And as you guys can see, the serving size here is 3.5. And it has a half a cup. So what I'm going to do is basically, you know, just put a cup of this in it. And I'm going to open it the same way as I did the potatoes. But instead of putting the whole can, I'm going to put a cup of tomatoes in there. And I'm going to take the rest and put it in a container. And place it in the refrigerator. And maybe tomorrow, I'll probably make some tomatoes and rice and salmon patties. Because that has definitely been a request. And I plan on doing that. If not tomorrow, I'll go ahead and move it Tuesday. Upload it so you guys can enjoy that too. And if you like what you see, you know, just like let me know in the comments, you know, how it turned out. And you know, if you have any more cooking ideas, any recipes that you like me to prepare, just let me know. My pleasure. You know, some foods that I cook, sometimes there's certain dishes that I don't eat, but someone in my family definitely loves to eat. So we can always try, you know? And we'll definitely succeed because, honey, I love to cook in the kitchen. And I like my recipes come out when it's a success, honey. Ooh, I'll just be so happy. So I'm going to go ahead and put a cup of diced tomatoes here. I'm just measuring in a cup here, guys, just to make sure I don't overdo it. Because like I said, this is the first time I'm actually trying to get inside of an Instant Pot. And you know what? I got all faith it's going to turn out just right. Just right. So I'm going to place that. Oh, my God, it smells so good. Inside the Instant Pot. Okay. Get it over there. And next thing I'm going to add is a little bit of seasoning. Some salt. Just a little bit of salt. Just a little bit, y'all. And then what I'm going to do, add just a little bit of this Lawry's. Y'all know my favorite. I love Lawry's. Lawry's seasoned salt because it's 25% less than sodium. Normally I use this all day, but I like to mix them together sometimes, just a little bit, and it comes out with a different flavor. So I'm going to go ahead and add a pinch of chopped chives. I love chopped chives. Just a little bit. Not too much. Just a pinch. A pinch is like, sorry, it just brings out the flavor, you know? Maybe just a little bit of pinch right here. Here we go. To wake up the flavor. There we go. That should certainly be enough right there. And of course, I add my parsley flakes when it actually comes to fruition, when it gets done. I add that for color. I love that. But anyway, guys, don't have to be afraid to season your meat. Use your choices of seasoning that you like. So what I'm going to do now, let that go. Place my tomatoes to the side and put it in the container. What I'm going to do now, guys, is go ahead and get my Instant Pot, go in, place it on, there, and I'm going to let it go, push pressure cook, for 30 minutes, because take it up to 30 minutes. And boom, I'm going to use my temperature is going to be normal on high pressure and just let it go from there. And now it's on. Now guys, I'm going to tell you something about what you want to do. I should have did first. I make sure it's sealed. This is no problem. And what I want to do is have a natural release. It's like, you know, when I can show you, but I don't want you guys to get too close. I don't want to burn myself or burn you. But what it does, you put it on seal, and just like as the meat gets, you know, starts cooking, it just naturally releases like psst, psst, psst. And then when it finally gets done, after it sits for a little while, I say about 10 minutes, then you push the pressure, psst, let all the pressure out. So right now it's cooking for next 30 minutes, and we'll see how it turns out. Oh God, it smells so good.